Calibrating a 3D printer can be a nightmare. Wouldn't it be great if, instead of having to play around with a million different settings, you could just print a bunch of stuff, pick the one that looks the best, and automatically get the right settings? Well, it turns out you can. I came across a new service called 3D Optimizer that tries to do exactly that. I was actually quite surprised by the results, so let's see how it works. Just to put the obvious out of the way, this isn't a sponsored video. The people behind 3D Optimizer didn't even know that I was making this video until the very end. In fact, since it's currently still in beta, all of the features are free for now, but I've bought a license anyway to support their work. As I've stated in my channel info over 2 years ago, I'm only doing reviews of things that I've purchased with my own money. I feel that's the only way to avoid any bias, and this video is no exception. So how exactly does it work? The basic idea is both simple and ingenious. It generates a G-code with a range of different settings, which you can then print out and simply pick the one that looks the best. You start by adding your printer and some basic settings. Some of the popular printers are already listed, but double check the values anyway. Next step is adding the material information. I really like this approach because you can then quickly optimize every new filament that you buy instead of having to waste time and plastic printing all the different torture tests. And finally, you can select what's most important to you: strength of your prints, how they look, or fast printing speeds. We'll go with the aesthetics for now, but I'll compare the other two later as well. You're now presented with a list of different tests, but you should start with the first one. Another great feature is that the tests build up on each other. As you determine the best printing speed, it saves it for later tests. The first test will determine the best height of your first layer and the optimal printing speed. It assumes that your bed is already properly leveled, so make sure it is. If you're not sure, I've made a bed leveling video a while ago that's quite popular, so check it out if you want to get near perfect results. Enter a range of values that make sense for your printer. All the values in between will automatically be calculated for you, so it's easy to try out different ranges. You can now generate the first G-code and start printing. Now simply inspect each part and decide which one looks the best. In this case, we're testing both first layer height and printing speed, so I want to pick one that's further down but still looks good enough. I'll go with this one. Now, remember the exact position, and then back at the page, simply pick the same one. Once you've confirmed your pick, you'll notice that the next test was skipped over. This is because the second test is optional and only needed if you have any gaps between the lines. As you work through the tests, a few others will be skipped as well. Don't worry about that and just do them as they're offered to you. Once you're finished, you can always go back and do some fine-tuning with the remaining tests. The second test will determine how fast you can print at different temperatures. This one might be a bit harder to decide, but if you're unsure, just pick what looks good and is within recommended temperature range for your filament. I'll go with this one, seems to be okay. Having skipped over quite a few tests, we now come to the test that I absolutely love, the rejection distance test. I always hated doing rejection tests, but this one is perfect because it tests different rejection settings in one go and it only takes a few minutes. Scrolling down, you can again see all the values that are locked in from the previous tests. Pick the first one where there's barely any stringing left. If you remember from my Hotend video, too much rejection can lead to blockages, so the goal is to have as little rejection as possible while still not having excessive stringing. The final test will determine best bridging settings. This is probably the hardest one to pick, as you'll soon see. The bridges are very short and shouldn't be a problem for any printer. However, that's not the point of this test. Instead, you're trying to determine which surface is the most even overall, that is, where there aren't many gaps and all the lines look about the same. It's probably easiest if you look at it with a light source behind. Try to pick one where the lines are all equal and where the gaps between them are smallest. Don't forget that you're choosing from all the triangles, not just the bottom ones. Once all the tests are done, you'll get a final report. Don't worry though, you won't have to enter all the values manually, because you can simply download the provided profile for your slicer. All three main ones are included. Before I started this, I've created a new default profile for my printer and did a test print. Let's compare that with the new settings from 3D Optimizer. While the stock settings aren't bad by any means, the new settings are still visibly better. I'm definitely impressed, and all the tests combined only took about 10 grams of plastic. I mentioned at the beginning that you could pick three different test goals: strength, aesthetics, and speed. Let's take a look at the differences between them. I've generated new profiles using default settings, and I've picked the same results for each one, so we can easily compare the differences. Doing a diff for all three profiles shows that there are only a few changes between them, as you can see here. I can't really argue with most of the choices. Sure, printing at 0.25 will be much faster than at 0.1, which will, in turn, produce better looking prints. I don't agree with all the infill choices though. When it comes to speed, rectilinear is indeed faster than most other infill types. Line infill is slightly faster, but only by a percent or two, so no real difference. It also tends to produce best looking top surfaces, so again, a good choice for aesthetics. The issue I have though is with the concentric when it comes to strength. Concentric is strongest only with 100% infill. In this case, however, the infill is set to 20%, at which point it becomes basically useless when it comes to horizontal load. Since it's not offering any support to the sidewalls, you might as well print the object hollow. A much better choice would be either honeycomb or jarred infill, since those two are the strongest for general use. Of course, keep in mind this is still in beta, so some issues are to be expected. Speaking of which, I actually found the first bug right away, but it only affected Prusa printers. Because of the different way that Prusa executes bed leveling command, running any test meant that the bed leveling would trigger twice before the test and twice again after. The leveling after the print was really troublesome, because as the printed object was still on the bed, the hotend could easily have hit it and potentially damaged something. I've emailed the developers and they responded back within a day, and by now, 2 weeks later, the bug has already been fixed. The second thing isn't an issue, but more of a request. While I love the current refraction test, I'd be thrilled to see more options like wipe and coasting settings. It'd also be great if the final profiles would be more fine-tuned for each slicer. For example, Simplified 3D has the best support for thin walls, while Prusa Slicer offers the jarred infill, which isn't available in the other two. Overall though, I really like the idea behind this project. As far as I know, nothing's been done like this before, where it guides you to different settings and you get to pick the best one. With traditional torture tests, you have to juggle between tons of settings at the same time, while here, you're only focusing on one or two. Sure, Key Slicer has the tuning wizard, but it doesn't test for as many settings and it's much more involved. It is free though, so I can't complain. In the end, 3D Optimizer is definitely not perfect, but I see it as a huge potential once it gets developed further. Even in its current state, it really does help, especially with tricky settings like retraction and bridging. And with that, have fun, and I'll see you soon.